This is about coming to this island with a sincere desire to hear from you and to hear your views and opinions on the pending acquisition docket before the Public Utilities Commission. So, how are we going to do it? Anybody who wants to speak, step up to the mic. We'll call you. You hear the clock, the timer. Please conclude your testimony. Please identify yourself before you commence your testimony, comments. Go ahead.
Aloha, commissioners, chair. My name is Barbara Haliniak. I'm a small business owner on Molokai, a retiree with GT Hawaiian Tel. My testimony is regarding one of NextEra's commitments published in the September 4, 2015 PBN, supporting local control and governance. NextEra reaffirmed its proposal to keep the local headquarters, local management, and the Hawaiian Electric name. For me, the meaning of an example of local control was when I was with GTE, well, I'm sorry, when Hawaiian Telephone Company was bought by GTE. The company went through so many changes. However, one of the most important component was keeping the Hawaiian Telephone name. So the company's name became GTE Hawaiian Tel, with local board members and executives, president, VPs, directors, etc., served by local talent, while GTE corporate headquarters operated in Irving, Texas. My job at GTE Hawaiian Tel was a tariff administrator providing FCC and PUC interpretation to company personnel and to respond to inquiries from the PUC staff. Prior to our department filing any GTE Hawaiian Tel PUC dockets, we met with intercompany to ensure that everyone was on board. Our department at times interfaced with the corporate office for other regulatory matters, but GTE local office was in control of the local tariff and the local services. Questions regarding tariff filings were received and responded by our department. The Irving, Texas corporate office did not dictate our responses, nor do we have to check with corporate before we initiate any responses. We had local control. Another example of local control is when I served as president of the Molokai Chamber of Commerce and became involved around October 2008 with Young Brothers, whose corporate office is in Seattle. I got an email from Young Brothers' local VP of Strategic Planning and Government Affairs advising that Young Brothers would be filing a PUC rate increase effective December of the same year. And as a courtesy, he forwarded a draft docket to me for my comments. I immediately challenged the LCR rate increase of 25%, citing that Young Brothers had a recent rate of reasonableness increase in August without going to public hearing, and that he must take that into consideration when applying the 25% increase for Molokai and Lanai. He asked me what would be a reasonable rate of increase, and I said 12%, and the reason why I said 12 was, I think the rate of reasonableness increase was 7%. I had a valid concern. The rate increase would have done devastation to Molokai and Lanai. He agreed to make the change in the docket. Okay, is that my
time? Yeah, please summarize.
Okay.
Please conclude.
Well, he made the change in the docket. He didn't go tell me he was going to corporate, and we got the 12% increase. So that's what I call local control.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Next, please identify yourself.
Good morning. My name is Karen Ashley.
Proceed.
And I'm here to talk about bees and smart meters. I just came from the mainland. I lived there for a year and a half, and there are no bees in towns that have smart meters. There's a lot of research to prove this. It's on Google, you can Google it, or especially you can see videos on YouTube, how microwaves damage bees. And it's not just smart meters, it's cell phones, it's microwave ovens, it's Wi-Fi. All kills bees, and we are still lucky here on Molokai that we even have bees, and we're not suffering from the varroa mite too much because of the chemicals that have been used on this island, particularly Roundup and other insecticides and pesticides. These also affect the bees, and a lot of people are afraid to speak about it because they don't want to offend the chemical companies, but without bees, we'd have to pollinate all our fruit ourselves.
Ms. Ashke, are you for or against the merger?
Oh, I'm against smart meters.
What about the acquisition?
Your Honor, sorry, sir, Mr. Wasi, I don't know.
Okay, thank you. That's it. Fine, thank you. Next.
Aloha. My name is Stacy Crivello, and you've introduced me as the council member, but today I'm wearing my hat as a Molokai resident, although we cannot get away from the other hats that we wear. I cannot say if I am for or against the merger at this time, because I feel there's that's going to be in your hands, and just like to give some bullet points for your consideration. When you consider the acquisition or the merger, there are several cleanups that needs to be done with HECO or MECO or the parent company. I'd like to start off, if you drive through our town, we have the old Molokai Electric site. And I believe Hawaiian Electric is responsible for the cleanup or in regards to the contamination, or at least to try and work with our community to get that place fixed up. There's no question about our existing infrastructure needs to be upgraded. And if somebody's coming in to buy a secondhand model, we need to be sure it's running good. We have a problem of the fuel costs with our Molokai rates. If we look at our electric bill, the fuel costs just kind of drives me up the walls. And so if we cannot put in our for a PV or whatever renewable we can to help and cut down our costs, because the grid cannot accept it, I think it's unfair. So those are the kind of things. I mean, even our schools, they have the problem of getting the ACs or put in renewable energy so that we can afford the costs. They can't do that, because unless you're going to go off the grid completely, and that's another story. But we should be able to have the infrastructure that we need to provide the kind of opportunities that are allowed out there if we can afford the PVs or what have you to cut the cost of our electricity. The other, I'm not the expert, but if we have a mainland outfit and if they have so many places that they operate from within the other part of the states, what about our corporate taxes? Does it stay here or does it go elsewhere that we lose out on that kind of benefit? Which reminds me that relationship is very important for our culture, our local culture. It's relationship and trust. And I think Ms. Heliniak just gave her opinion about that. And I also retired from the same company she came from. And so we know what it is to have to deal with the mainland outfit as opposed to the local structure. I hope that the PUC will take into serious consideration.
Can you summarize?
Okay, that's it?
You can summarize.
All right. The important thing, I hope you will take into deep consideration how, though we're an island, I believe we're rural and we still need the opportunity to be provided the kind of infrastructure we need so that we can cut costs and have the right sort of service. Mahalo.
Thank you. Next. And please state your name and your position if you feel comfortable with doing so. Go ahead.
Good morning.
Good morning.
I'm Rita Woods, and I've been on Molokai almost 5 years now, so I'm a newcomer. And just to get it out of the way, I'm opposed to the merger between NextEra and the Hawaiian Electric Company, mainly because I've been on the mainland for most of my life, and I've seen that huge corporations tend to be for their stockholders and not specifically for the people. I have family in Florida, and they've not been impressed with NextEra there. I just don't think that this particular area, the Hawaiian Islands, need a great big conglomerate. Each island is entirely different with different energy needs, and I don't think that one huge umbrella can cover the entire Hawaiian islands. Thank you.
Thank you, Ms. Woods. Thank you. Next.
Hi. My name is Larry Toole. I'm a Molokai resident. Let me first thank you for bringing this issue to the public. I realize you don't have to do that, and I'm grateful that you did. I wrote this out, but I'm not sure it's 3 minutes, so I'll summarize. My concern here, and I'm opposed to the merger, and the reason is I'm concerned about long-term investment. We've got an island-by-island set of problems. One size doesn't fit all. We've got a company that's been here twice as long as the state. I've watched the commission try to get that company to perform, to invest. You've made a lot of efforts in that direction, but there's a lot of resistance. So my question for NextEra is, what is their incentive to upgrade all the different grids and plants in this state to really do all the things you're trying to do? Because you're not trying to do one thing. You're trying to do reliable service. You're trying to do environmental cleanliness. You're trying to do ratepayer relief. It's a lot to do at one time. So I listen to these guys. I watch them. They are good salesmen. They've made a lot of commitments. But if you read the fine print, it says a commitment is just a forward-looking statement, and a forward-looking statement has nothing to do with performance down the road. So I'm skeptical that they would actually be able and willing, they're able, that they would be willing to do the long-term investments where they wouldn't see a profit in 10 or 15 years. That doesn't make it easier, that makes it harder. If the deal falls through, we still have HECO, we have a lot of problems. But it seems to me the state needs to take the lead, maybe even finance the big investment, and then put out to bid the service and operations. But that's my concern. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Woods. Atul. Next.
Cheryl Corbio, resident of Molokai. I am against the NextEra merger. Big is not better any longer. In the 1930s, co-ops grew up, and that's how we got electrification. Then companies came in and bought up all of the electrification in America, and then we ended up with big utilities. But we have seen a trend where big companies implode, and we are going back to small companies. Municipalities on the mainland are going back to being their own utility again. So I'm not sure why Hawaii would want to get into a situation with a company that owns 900 other companies to think that they would get any attention, especially here on Molokai. We have 2,000 customers. The current utility does not really service or listen to the needs of the customers here. And one of the reasons is because they don't make any money here. And we understand that. And as you are probably aware, Molokai is looking at potentially being a co-op. We also are supportive of Maui County pursuing other options to potentially help us so that we don't have to try and set up our own utility, because we have limited resources here and limited human capacity. And so that's the one thing that is a big barrier for us. So the Nextron deal, when they were here, they showed their colors loud and clear by coming in arrogantly with a big PR campaign. Even told us they had not looked at the books. They didn't really know what they would do for us. All they said was that they thought they could instantly save $16 million, but couldn't say really how. And so they got a lot of money, but they do not have the vested interest of Hawaii or the individual islands. Individual islands, as Kauai has shown, need to look at their own system. The same is true of Molokai, Maui, Oahu, Big Island. The energy needs will be met in a small way, not in a grand way. So that whole idea of somehow going into a bigger entity is not the model that's going forward. If you do an internet search on the about companies and trends, all of them will say that there needs to be a changing perspective in energy and that you need to go smaller, you need to go very specific, you need to do things that customers are willing to pay for, and that is not what NextEra would give Hawaii or specifically to Molokai. And so with no plan said in any of their documents, I am terrified. So I'd rather stay with the devil I know than the big devil that's sitting out there as NextEra. So I'm adamantly against it, and it does not follow the logic of where energy utilities are going anyplace else in the world. In Europe, municipalities are going back and being their own municipalities and getting out of big energy agreements. The trend is reversing. We need to stay where we are and move forward for sure. Thank you.
Thank you. Next. Anyone else?
My name is Kimo Dobranson. I'm a resident, and thank you for being here and listening to our concerns. I am against this merger, and the reason I'm against it, because it's just nothing more than more of the same. I'm concerned about the carbon footprint, but not only that, we have an opportunity now to change the whole playing field here. What I'm suggesting to you is to think about, instead of burning fossil fuels, think about a closed-loop hydro system, in which we have a reservoir at the top of the mountain and we have high pressure pipes coming down and we use turbines and then we use panels and or wind generators to pump that water back up, and we are producing our electricity. That huge reservoir at the top acts as a giant battery. We can control the amount of power. In the evening we can cut it back. In the busy time of the day, we open it up and have more water coming down, thus producing more electricity, thus not burning any carbon fuel. And Molokai is set up. You could put the first system in here and show it how it could work in the rest of the state. Every island is set up perfectly for a closed-loop hydro. The reason it's not had been done before, of course, fossil fuels, big thing. There's a lot of money in that. But up until recently, we haven't had the ability to produce electricity with panels and wind power to pump the water back up. That has changed, thus making a closed-loop hydro system an unbelievably wonderful option for us. I'm suggesting that we change the playing field, do this differently, and do it correctly, and we'll be done, and our carbon footprint will be almost nil. And we will not be dependent on ships coming in, bringing in fuel for us, and we're just burning more fuel, and, well, you know the rest of the story. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Before we go on, I'd like to take this opportunity on behalf of the commission to introduce my friend over there, Colette Machado. Colette, how are you? Okay. OHA trustee. So, no, not you. You're not the OHA trustee. Come.
My name is Pualani Akaka. I'm a grade 4 teacher, and I've been teaching in the public school for 26 years. And I am here because I teach every day renewable energy, conservation, getting along together, anti-bullying, and it makes no sense to me to be teaching the children how to take care of the world and for us to set up a framework that is going to work against what they have a chance to do and what they've been learning every day in school. That they be able to look at the resources that we have and be able to make them work in a clean and renewable way. And I don't see this merger as being a way to make them have a fighting chance to move us forward and us to have a balanced nation where we can, as a nation, we do our contribution. And we do this every day in the classroom, and so I would like to see that supported by the adults. Thank you.
So, excuse me, Ms. Akaka, you're opposed?
I am opposed.
Okay, thank you.
I am opposed. Thank you.
Next, anyone else?
may need to adjust this, so pardon me.
You can take it out of that thing too, I think.
Okay, that might work a little better.
Well, aloha and good morning, commissioners. Thank you for being here. Far too often, Molokai is left out.
Identify yourself, please.
Pardon me, I'm sorry. My name is Rob Stevenson, and I'm the president of the Molokai Chamber of Commerce, and speaking on behalf of the Molokai Chamber of Commerce. And far too often, Molokai is left out of discussions, especially those discussions where, in the big picture, we as a small rural community have little or no political or economic influence on a particular situation, yet our families and businesses have to survive. But ironically, during these times, we often experience significant effects that are completely beyond our ability to manage and control. What's happening today, though, is a welcome departure from that. We as a community are being considered and our voices are being heard. The issue before us is an opportunity where, given the plans of NextEra Hawaii, we may see a significant impact to our island residents and businesses. Each of us here, our neighbors, our family, our friends, and those who couldn't join us today. And this impact has the potential to make a real and lasting positive change in many ways by providing possible hope for our island's ratepayers. Hope that our energy costs will no longer financially cripple our already cash-strapped businesses and families. Hope that our energy needs will be met with greater reliability and efficiency. Hope that the vast resources of NextEra Energy will help our island community transition into the shared future of Hawaii's clean energy and sustainability goals. We'd like to welcome, and many thanks to NextEra Energy President Eric Gleason and his team for being here today, but not just for today. Mr. Gleason and the NextEra Energy team have visited our island several times, some in a formal capacity and others less formal. It's his simple leadership style of reaching out to the community, the broad community, by going to meet with small groups of people to have real, authentic conversations that makes all the difference. He and his team haven't done this to come and tell us what we want to hear or tell us how things should be done. They've been here to listen how we feel, to learn things that are important to each of us and our families and our businesses, to help them develop the best plans to help us make a difference in our lives. Our businesses,
all your support?
Yes, sir. Our businesses are the backbone of our island economy, and they're struggling, yet they help to keep Molokai going. The needed reduction of energy costs and an increase in reliability of service as a result of this merger will undoubtedly strengthen our community. And as an organization that represents dozens of businesses, hundreds of their employees, and over 1,000 of their family members, the Molokai Chamber of Commerce supports programs that will make a positive difference in our business community that supports the livelihood of our families. And for the reasons I've given, and many others, we're here to extend our support for the NextEra Energy and the proposed merger with Hawaiian Electric Industries. Thank you for your consideration.
Thank you. Next, anyone else wishing to speak?
Hello there. Thanks for coming. My name's Ken Baer. I'm definitely against the merger. The first issue on your docket there, whether the proposed transaction is in the public interest. And I certainly agree with Stacy Crivello there. Before any kind of thing happens, the cleanup needs to be done here. You need to know from these people that it will be cleaned up. It's in the middle of our town. It's unusable. It's an eyesore. It's an environmental hazard. It needs to be cleaned up, and these people that stand to profit millions need to do it. Number one. Number two, but really the number one thing that I want to address is climate change. Bringing in LNG, yes, maybe on the surface it seems like a good idea, but you got to look out 20 or 30 years that the infrastructure is going to take to pay back. What technologies are going to come down in the next 20 or 30 years. We're investing in something that is just the same old stuff. And the way this electrical company has worked has been a cost plus. The more it costs, the more money they make. That's got to end in this world. What we're looking at, there was a climate report from NASA, July of this year, and they say they're wrong about climate change, that it's happening much faster than expected. 2 degrees centigrade atmospheric change has been deemed the safe level. This report from NASA says that if we have a 2 degree atmospheric change in temperature, we'll have catastrophic sea level rise. If we don't go 100% renewable, and we have a wonderful opportunity now to do that, we are threatening ourselves. We don't have to worry about business in Kanakakai. 5 foot sea level rise in 50 years, they're saying possibly 10. There won't be any businesses in town. And what does this leave our children and our community? We have to think more big picture than saving maybe 5 cents a kilowatt hour because we brought in LNG and hopefully we can make it back in 20 or 30 years. That is a, it just doesn't work. We need strong political, drag them down. They're not gonna do it easily. These big electrical companies are not gonna do what's right. This community's got to stand up, and you people have got to stand up and say, we need to go 100% renewable.
Please summarize. Thank you. Next. Come on up.
I'm David Kangas. Thank you very much for this.
You're welcome.
For being here. I'm totally against the merger. I totally agree with Cheryl and others, but particularly Cheryl, 1,000%. We don't need more awful, insidious, invidious lies and a pernicious play of politics from Meco, Echo and NextEra. You know, they want to lower their rates. That'll never happen. We know that. They won't even stabilize. And on the mainland, they're promoting nuclear energy, natural gas by fracking. That's pretty awful. We don't want that. They are totally opposed to solar energy. And they just want to increase profits in their monopoly and wreck Hawaii, especially here, especially Molokai. What we need, and I think what we will get, like Kauai, is rate payer owned co-ops. That's the only way. Thank you.
Thank you. Anyone else? Morning.
My name is Roshani Nash, and I'm a resident. I'm adamantly against this merger. The proposed merger would diminish competition in the state. NextEra does not have a good track record for solar rooftop systems, and I believe that the future for energy needs in the Hawaiian Islands should be met by a decentralized energy generation. I think that even the size of HECO is a problem because we feel, I belong to an area of Molokai that is Kawela Plantation, and we spend about $100,000 a year generating electricity to, or rather we buy electricity worth $100,000 every year to provide water to our residents. In January of this year, they decided that they weren't going to accept any more net energy metering applications. And I just wonder what would happen with a company as big as NextEra, because I think people would be powerless to deal with a company this huge. A multi-billion dollar company like NextEra would result in the PUC having even less control than it does now, I think. And I really believe that we all need to
really thank whoever did this brochure. It's a really complex issue, so it's really hard for a lot of us to understand those complex issues. But this really, the questions that you folks put out really help us to understand the issue in a much more simple way. So one of the things I wanted to say is that when you come out of the airport, you see two signs. It says keep Molokai, Molokai, and what's the other? Come on, what's the other sign, guys? Slow down, this is Molokai. And I think that really does reflect this community. I can recall a bunch of years ago when we did the effort for biomass using one of our natural resources, kiawe trees. We all know what the results of that was. It actually increased our energy costs, which we're still having to deal with. But I want to also point out that we still use that resource. We use it as firewood. to do our smoking of our meat, to pulehu our meat. So I guess my point is that I think we really want to keep Molokai Molokai, and I think people have who have come up previously have pointed out that you know, cooperatives seems to be a really good thing that we should explore for the reasons given. Each island is very different. This community was very clear about not wanting to create wind energy that goes off island and we don't get the benefits. And I don't think that's a selfish message. I think the message was we all got to solve our own problems, you know, so that we can support each other in that problem solving manner. And one of the things that I really appreciated was to me the question of whether the proposed transaction approved will enhance or detrimentally impact the state's energy goals. I'm glad Pua mentioned about the future generations. It's going to be their kuleana. And so I really think we got to think hard about the implications for the future generations. And I guess for me, it, you know, you got to kind of look for where you can get the information. And for most of us, it's through the newspapers, the news medias, and through our government. And it's been really clear. What I hear is that they're not going to help us in terms of energy. Our governor's come out very strong about his concerns. And so for me, there's a lot of clear messages from us as a community and I think us as a state that this is not a good idea. Thank you.
Thank you. Next.
My name is Arthur Parr and I'm opposed to the merger. Lived in Molokai now for about 15 years. Molokai is unique, and a lot of people say we're unique because of the culture. Other people say we're unique because we have the highest rate of unemployment. We pay more at the gas pump than anybody. Groceries are high, and we pay nearly 50 cents a kilowatt hour for power, where our relatives on the mainland pay an average of 11 cents. NextEra, as I understand it, they want to convert our fuel for energy from diesel to LNG. That may save us 10 or 20 bucks a month, possibly, if anything. They'll probably want us to pay for the conversion. We need to be able, or we need to have available to us rooftop units, rooftop solar. It's the one method of power generation that I think is the most efficient and can be the most beneficial to all of our neighbors. NextEra has demonstrated in Florida that they're opposed to rooftop solar, and I think we need to have rooftops so that we can meet this 100% renewable in whatever that time span is that's been established by the state. Is it by 1950, I believe, or excuse me, 2050. I think NextEra is a bad organization for Hawaii, and I think you should do whatever you can to discourage them from being here. Thank you.
Thank you.
Aloha and thank you for this opportunity. My name is Jantel Durua Lindo and I'm a Keikiokaina of Molokai. In fact, my family's been here for, I'm fifth generation. So I can tell you that through the process of growing up and being here, I know that life here is not as easy when you look at it on a social scale when you talk about electricity and money and economic benefit and those kinds of things. But I can tell you that we are rich in a lot of other things. And when I look at this issue, I cannot say that I stand in support of any particular company or any particular merger. What I can tell you is I stand in support of moving forward. And if this merger means that we're going to get out of what we're in and at least have a tangible solution, not something we hypothetically thinking about or have no money to pull through, everybody has a good idea of what an alternative energy world would look like. But how many actually come to the table with tangible, reliable resource to pull that effort off? So my testimony today is I stand in support of moving forward for our island. And yes, it's scary, but there are two main things that prohibit us from being able to be truly blessed and endure and go forward and be productive as a community, and that's fear and pride. So as humanity, we gotta stop putting our fear and pride aside and looking for solutions that mean something. I heard people say NextEra is this and that and they're not gonna be good, they hate rooftop, they hate all this kind of stuff. Well, I sat down with the gentleman last night. I was there, one of only five people who took the time to actually sit down and have an intimate conversation. He told me in my face to my eyes that he's not opposed of rooftop, that they are totally in support of all kinds of different alternative energy ideas. So I'm not sure where everybody's getting their information, whether it's Google or whatever it is. I can tell you that in our culture, it means something when you're sitting down next to somebody, you invite them in your home, you tell them straight to face to face, and you all you can do is take their word. And if it fails, it fails, and we move on as a people. We've done that historically for hundreds and hundreds of years, indigenous people have. So today I stand in support of doing something. Please don't leave us stagnant. Please don't leave us with just one choice. It's not right to just be stuck with one choice. And so I just want to thank you guys. I know it's a hard job, and I thank you for coming. Thank you.
Thank you. Next, anyone else wishing to testify or provide comment? Again, you please state your name and, if you want to, what position you take on the docket issue.
My name is Elaine Callanan, and I am opposed to this merger. What Molokai in particular needs is a system of decentralized distributive energy, not corporate takeover. NextEra's main interest is bottom line. And I don't see anything in what they've presented so far that gives me any security that they have our interests at heart. These questions that you have in this brochure, excellent. But and when I look at the questions, I come up with a no for every single one of them. So I stand opposed.
Thank you. Next, I know someone stood up.
Aloha.
Aloha.
My name is Kano Hawaii Lukuhiam, from Aialoha Molokai. Just want to thank you guys for coming out to Molokai today.
Could you repeat your name again?
Kano Hawaii Lukuhiam.
Okay, thank you.
Okay. I guess I wanted to share a vision with you guys, what I see for Molokai and what I hope for, wish for thinking. And I don't know what way this can come about. We talked about co-op, municipal utility. We have a merger going on. Talk about co-op again. I hope to see people raise their hands because it's going to be hard work. I hope people in the community are ready for hard work if we do a co-op, because it's going to take people to come out, not just talk about it. That's going to be for real. It's going to be hard work. If you get serious about a co-op, then raise your hand. You have to raise your hand, you have to come out, and you have to support it, and you have to come to the meetings, and we have to talk about it, and you have to be real about it. Can't just come to the meeting and say, we like to do a co-op, and then not do it. That's to be real. You know, otherwise, you know, we're beholden to the larger company, one with resources and whatnot. I have a vision that we put solar rooftop on our high school, our gym, and that we have a place for emergency preparedness up there in case something goes wrong with the central part of the island. that people have a place to go. Maybe a place to go for the whole state in case there's a disaster out there. Molokai has above sea level airport, and it'd be a place, a staging area, in case there's a disaster throughout the state. And it's a way where Molokai can give back to the rest of the state as well. We gotta look at ways where we can give back, you know, and not be selfish, you know. I don't think that's through a cable or through a huge industrial development, such as Big Wind, and I hope that's off the table. I have a vision that we can look at bottom-up planning. We can sit down as a community and make decisions together, and hopefully have some redundancy. We have different areas where we can fall back on, and we can start to take care of each other. I think that's the way, you know, the way things are moving anyway. And I really hope if people are serious about a co-op that that they start raising their hand, because you know, tired of talking. We've been involved with this for so long already, many years, and we gave our time. I gave a lot of time into these issues of energy.
Mr. Sam, please summarize.
I hope people raise their hand. That's all.
So you take no position on the
right now. I oppose the merger.
Okay, thank you. Next. Hold on, we're going to get bananas. Oh, thank you. Go ahead.
Okay, I'm Poena Newhart. I'm a Holyhua homesteader. My main concern is I'm against NextEra. And every time they talk about liquid gas, I kind of go berserk. Now, if this is in connection to fracking, I am completely against it. We want our island to be pono with the land, and then we're going to go someplace else and make there's no pono? No. I'm against NextEra.
Thank you. Anyone else? Please.
My name is Cheryl Pritchard, and I am opposed to the NextEra merger. NextEra is in the business of selling natural gas, and proposing to put in an infrastructure to do the same here, and that's not the infrastructure we need. It is time for humans on this planet to stop externalizing our costs of our being. And NextEra, in its partnership as the largest purveyor of natural gas, is externalizing the costs to everyone on this planet. And I also do not want to be a part of it. Thank you.
Thank you. Anyone else? Anyone else?
My name is Kimo Kalaniopuu McPherson. I have my own private home up in Kamililoa Heights since 1972. I have been a ratepayer since then. So that's a long time that we've been focusing on Payne Electric Company. From big bucks. When I first started, when I got my first bill, it said 1,200 kilowatt hours per month. Then it went to 800 kilowatt hours. Then it supposedly was supposed to be 600 kilowatt hours a month that you're paying your electric bill on. 2 days ago, I was in a library, and every day you read the newspaper, if you read the newspaper, you're on the computer, you are knowledgeable. You know what's happening. You know what the questions are. But to come and read the newspaper on all the negativity about NextEra, and to find out that we are Molokai and Lanai are paying 400 kilowatt hours a month. Somehow we're feeling, I'm feeling we're getting screwed either in the beginning or in the end, we're getting screwed. And we're still paying the highest price. Now, the focus here is, am I for NextEra? And all of these questions you're asking, the word is no, negative. And I'm not here to educate you on what the alternatives are, because it's all around you. All you gotta do is read. But I have some interesting information from the computer on a lot of these firms that are telling you why NextEra is not good. If I were a PUC commissioner, I would say, what's your business plan? If NextEra wants the deal to be approved, it's going to have to explain the financials and how it's going to make money. And if the business plan it puts forward is not in line with the policy of the state, I think it's incumbent on the commission to say NO. So, what is left? What we are here for is the interest, in the interests of the ratepayers, not in a corporate takeover. $4.3 billion is the cost of Hawaiian Electric's takeover, 33 cents a kilowatt hour on Oahu, and higher on Molokai and Lanai. 2030 is Hawaiian Electric's, what you call, set goal to triple PV solar. All you gotta do is look at our biggest market where we get all our food, which is Friendly Market Center, and they have $1 million on their roof, all in photovoltaic. That tells you somebody knows what to do.
Please summarize.
Is that summarized?
Summarize, yes.
Okay, here we go. Florida-based publicly traded company that is beholden to its shareholders to get the best return on the investment, not the customer in Hawaii, that are dependent on a sole energy provider.
Thank you. Next.
Good morning, my name's Les Wiley. I'm a permanent resident of Molokai, living on the West End. I'm here representing my wife and myself. I oppose the HECO NextEra merger, and like to start off by just telling two short little stories. The first one, the California State University years ago opened their newest campus, the Channel Islands campus at Camarillo, California. Unlike most architects, the campus architect put in all the buildings, but he didn't put any walkways. And you say, why didn't you put in the walkways? But what they did was they opened the campus. The people wandered around the campus for 6 months, going through doing their business. And then after that, the architect went down and looked at it. This is how the people use the campus. This is where they go. This is how they get there. And then he put in the sidewalks. So the sidewalks go where the people want to go, not where the architects want them to go. Hawaii is kind of like that. We have six islands with different problems about providing energy for the people of those islands. Each has a different solution. And like Kanoho said, I think we need a bottom-up solution, not a top-down solution from a company that's located 5,000 miles away. My second thing is I want to remind you of a story I think we're all familiar with, the story of the Scheherazade, 1001 Nights, and the genie and the bottle. I want to tell you, if you haven't heard the story, I'll tell you my version of the story. This guy's walking down the beach in Waikiki. He's an engineer, politician, member of this commission. And he has been going to school. He went to Caltech, he went to Harvard Law. He never had a chance to read 1001 Nights. He looks down at his feet, and there is a little lamp. It's perfectly unscratched or anything, and he picks it up. And he does not know the story about the genie and how the genie offers three wishes and the disastrous outcome that comes as a result. So he brushes the genie, or brushes the lamp off, and poof, all of a sudden there's a giant genie standing in front of him. He's blue, he has a big giant t-shirt that's got a lightning bolt on it. It says, NextEra, genie at your service. And the guy says, wow, this is kind of cool. And the genie says, well, I am really happy to get out of this bottle. I've been living on the East Coast for 5,000 miles from here for a long time, and I would sure love to get out here in the Pacific, and you've made it possible for me. I can come out here and lay on the beaches and be really happy. So I'll grant you three wishes. The guy says, well, I've got a headache. I've had a problem all along. I've got to supply power for all these islands. Each one has a different problem. I need a lot of money, and I got.
You have to summarize your joke. However you can get to it.
Okay, well.
Get to that punchline, guys.
Basic idea, as we all know, when you get the three wishes from the genie in the form of NextEra, you always rue the day. And that's what I'm saying here. I think the genie, if we let the genie out of the bottle, we're going to pay for it.
Thank you. Next, anyone else? Anyone else wishing to testify? Yes, come on up.
Aloha kākou. My name is Karen Holt, and I'm the head of a local nonprofit organization here on Molokai. And I also participated in the integrated resource planning process that HECO convened in 2012. Went to most of the meetings along with a couple of other folks in this room. The result of those meetings was really disappointing for me, because Molokai, as everybody has said, is a unique community with unique needs. And basically, the result of all of that planning for Molokai was status quo. And that demoralized me, because many of the ideas that have been brought to the table over the years would need the company's support in order to move forward on them. Our organization, just to support something that our council member mentioned in her testimony, has been trying for almost 15 years or more to get this brownfield cleaned up. Molokai Electric, when it was at its original location, right in the middle of town, put a lot of toxic chemicals into the ground, and it cannot be redeveloped until all of that is taken care of. So what I really wanted to say is that HECO was a disappointment to me. And of course, it's still a disappointment to all of us, because we still pay incredibly high rates. And periodically, nobody can apply to put solar on their roof. I don't know NextEra. And I know that this is still in the middle of a negotiation process. If I were just going to look at this self-interestedly from the perspective of our community, the question that I would be asking, but I don't have an answer to it, is how would they be serving Molokai in a way that met Molokai's needs? The idea of putting together an electric cooperative is very old. People were talking about it in the 80s, and that's because everybody on this island secretly is a MacGyver. If you want something done, right, Longi? You go in your backyard, you figure out what a wire is and whatever, and you put it together. That's how this community operates. And it's one of the reasons that it has such a low per household consumption rate. It's probably the lowest in the country. And I've been fascinated by all the ways that people have figured out to take a warm bath, Kiavi fire, in an old water heater that's been put on top of a fireplace. If you really want to watch your television and you don't have electricity, you go hook up to your car battery. So this is a pretty inventive place, and it has all come out of the fact that, unfortunately, our electric company is not able to provide affordable and reliable service. The idea of pumped hydro using our reservoirs is probably the best way to go on this island, and maybe on others. The only one that uses that mechanism right now is Kauai. But it was part of the HECO IRP process, and it was never introduced into the plan. So my bottom line right now is that I really have to say I'm kanalua. I don't know.
Can you summarize?
Yes, I just summarized. I'm not sure. But I think the question for me would be answered when I find out what HECO can do for Molokai and what NextEra can do for Molokai. So good luck.
Thank you. Morning, Colette.
Aloha. You folks jammed up my Saturday. I was supposed to go up to the Taro Field Day at the Maui Community College Farm, and I'm here today because I can't remember when the last time the Public Utilities Commission appeared on Molokai. So this is big news. So I look at the commission, all three of you, that's you, Randy, that's Michael Champley, and Lorraine Akiba. You were supposed to advocate for us and scrub down this NextEra application. I believe that your mission is intended to regulate and not only telecommunication, but registered public utility companies. And then I looked at your frequently asked questions. I believe that this is what this is. You provided 1 to 6 questions. If I'm here to look at a small view as a resident of this island, not as a elected official with the Office of Hawaiian Affairs, I would say that all of this is your task, 1 through 6, and I think that's why you put it on this publication for us to consume. For me, I want to advocate any way that Molokai can be separated from Oahu's needs and the larger islands. Please consider that. I think you've heard discussions over the possibility of a cooperative, whether or not that's appropriate to negotiate, because there's an area here that you can propose transactions that you can negotiate. I'm not sure how you can look at Molokai and how we can become a very unique entity in all of this, because we feel like we're getting swallowed up by a David and Goliath arrangement. You know, our residence structure is less than 8,000. Our user use is even less, and we have high delinquency rates, I'm pretty sure. So we don't have the ability to say we want voice to be reckoned with. I know Oahu is with the kind of planned communities they're projecting for. But all I can say to you is please consider some other input here. And my position right now is to say no, because there's inadequate information that has not been provided. There's already the possibility of some litigation from Earth Justice being leveraged against this merger. But I personally feel that we always advocate as the David Goliath, that you folks are the giants, or NextEra is the giants, you folks are our advocates, and we want you to be encouraged to do all you can to advocate for us small people here, as has been conveyed to you. So anyway, I'm left to go to an event called Pai Lolo Challenge. We have 40 plus canoes coming from DT Fleming's Beach that will end up in front of the yacht club, and that starts at 12. So I have time for that, and I thank you all for coming. Really, this is a big day for Molokai, that the Public Utilities Commission made an effort to hear from us. So my position is no, until we're able to see a little bit more tweaking where Molokai could be able to carve out what would be okay for us to swallow. So mahalo, Randy and Lorraine, you're looking good.
Thank you. Hey, Colette, what about me? I look good too. I'm bald head.
That's just good to say. Nice and clean.
University of Hawaii. Yeah. Okay, thank you, Colette. Anyone else? Come on up.
Hello. My name is John Longi Dudwa. I'm a Kekokaina of Molokai, born and raised at Manai from 1949. I'm also the vice commander of our veterans, Molokai Veterans Caring for Veterans, down at our new vet center, which was opened last month, September 14th. We had a grand opening at our new vet center. We finally opened up after 10, 12 years of trying to get it done. But anyway, what I'm saying is that I'm not for or I'm not against. I still have more to find out what's happening, because we're trying to get solar top for our veteran center, because our Molokai electric rates, the electrical rates are $500 to $600 a month. And we're self-sufficient. We don't have any money that comes in from the federal government to help us. We have the county, and thank you to our councilwoman, Stacey Crivello, and our mayor that has helped us along the way. So what I'm trying to say, I talked to Matt Yamashita. I called him up about a month ago and inquired about solar for our veteran center and try to see what we could do with that. And then Matt informed me that they had a moratorium in Molokai, that they stopped all applications and all solar systems for the island. So what I'm here for is, okay, what do we do? So they got the moratorium because the grid, there's not enough to go on the grid. So why don't we here to upgrade the grid and get it so we can get solar, more power here on Molokai for the Molokai people. I'm not for and I'm not against, because there's more. I think I've got to listen. I think our veterans got to listen to that. And but I hopefully, and I thank you, commissioners, for coming. And hopefully we can get something done, you know, and with HECO, and get this moratorium lifted. Okay, but thank you to the Rising Suns, Matt. He was helping, and he told me, well, we cannot do it because we're on a moratorium. But anyway, thank you very much, Commissioners.
Thank you, Mr. Duong. Anyone else wishing to present comment. Come on up.
Aloha, my name is Richard Ellerson. I'm also a Molokai veteran. And it was kind of my basic idea to put solar on our building. And I have a question that I can't understand. I explained to Longy that there's an option of us buying all kind of storage batteries for backup and everything, going completely off the grid and just go, but that's not the way the utility companies want it. So the question I have is, why don't the utility companies get some backup storage or something so they don't have this problem? Thank you.
Thank you. Anyone else?
Good morning, and I would also like to express my appreciation. Sorry. Hold it. Okay, how's that? Okay. that the PUC came to Molokai in order to listen to us. And my name is Amelia Nordhook. I am the executive director of Sustainable Molokai and co-founder. We work in many different areas, and one of those areas is in energy efficiency, and we've switched out refrigerators, light bulbs, all sorts of stuff, and done audits, trained kids to go into homes and help people on Molokai become even more energy efficient than they already are. at this point, with the negotiations, I'm still in the middle. I'm not sure whether this is a good deal for Molokai or the state of Hawaii. I do have three things that I would like the PUC to make public. One of them is that we need to know the plan. You don't spend $4.7 billion to have a plan to come up with a plan. So there's a plan, and we'd really like to have the transparency and be able to see what exactly that is and how Molokai figures into that. If there is a local advisory board, what authority will it actually carry, and will Molokai have a representative or only Maui County? And finally, is there a commitment through the merger that Molokai, which is small enough to achieve 100% renewable energy faster than anywhere else in the state, can NextEra commit to making the island 100% renewable by 2020 with the use of solar and storage? And I think that until those concerns and those questions are addressed, that I'll have to stay probably on the in the middle or on the other side of being against the merger. Thank you so much.
Thank you. Anyone else?
Before you start the clock, I got one procedural question. I'm just wondering, do people have an opportunity to come up and do another 3 minutes after everyone has spoken? Okay. When was the last time you guys were on Molokai? The PUC? I mean, do you guys have that? I just out of curiosity. Okay. It is good to see you guys here. I'm glad you guys came. I'm really grateful. I'm even more grateful to our own community for showing up on a Saturday morning, which is a really, really bad time normally for our community to meet. I think if this meeting was held, like on Maui and the other islands, in the evening after work, on a work day, you would probably see 3 or 4 times the amount of people here. I know a lot of people emailed me back saying that unfortunately, they won't be able to make it. So hopefully you'll be getting a lot of written testimony from them. My name is Matt Yamashita. Born and raised in Molokai. Our family is called Molokai Home for 5 generations. I used to be employed in the solar industry. I'm actually a full-time filmmaker. I say used to be because as of January, Miko essentially shut down net metering for the entire island of Molokai, and we still don't see any resolution for how they're gonna address that. So it's very unfortunate for our island. We lost a lot of jobs, and a lot of residents lost the opportunity to see the savings that come with residential solar that everybody on the other islands are still seeing. And if I had an extra 3 minutes, I'd go into more detail on my concerns about that. As far as NextEra goes, they came to visit us one time, and during that, little bit more background. I'm not gonna preach to the choir. I am opposed to NextEra. I've been following the hearings very closely. I've been following the news very closely, and I oppose and share the same concerns as all of the interveners, as a governor, as our legislators. And from what I understand, so far your community meetings across the islands have shown probably like 90% community opposition to NextEra. So I'm in that same boat. Personally, where my biggest concerns stand is, you know, when NextEra came, I did research prior to them coming. And what I found was that their track record was very questionable and really didn't match the needs of our own island and or the needs of our state and our communities. When I brought that up, you know, I was told, I was reading the wrong articles and I should do more research and I'll find some positive stuff. I spent almost every day spending a little bit of time researching NextEra since, and I cannot find anything good about them on the internet except for on their own website. And so, you know, when we talk about hope for what this corporation might bring, or when we talk about the hypotheticals of what alternative might be, right now everything they're promising in my mind is a hypothetical that I can't be hopeful for because the track record isn't there. I mean, you look at FPL's, where their energy comes from, 68% natural gas, 23% nuclear, 4% coal, less than 1% is from PV
please
power. So I'm talking track record. And that's enough for me. Yep.
Thank you. Anyone else wishing to provide comment?
Aloha, my name is William Kalipi. I'm opposed. And also I wasn't on Molokai that long, a little under 50 years, born and raised here. Probably 10, 20 generations from here. I heard plenty of guys talking and, you know, the chambers of Molokai or this or that, and don't even know if I know their face or their family. Molokai is a tight knit family. I come from one place where I think if you sell to someplace, somebody from the U.S., you're only gonna make it a little bit more cloudy when our government, the Hawaiian sovereignty, come back. You're only kind of jamming everything up. Somebody gotta be responsible for all the wrong that have been done to Hawaiians. Right now, Castle and Cook on Oahu trying to sell all their lands. Alexander and Baldwin on Maui trying to sell their lands. Everybody trying to get out because they don't want to be responsible. If or whatever, what happens, I think should get a clause in there. Whoever, you know, if you guys do sell anything, the origin people who was involved in it should still be responsible after everything is said and done when Hawaii get its own government back. Okay, aloha.
Aloha. Anyone else? Anyone else? If not, this will conclude the hearing. I would like to reemphasize.
My name's Todd Yamashita, and I'm speaking on behalf of myself as a ratepayer. I'd like to give up my 3 minutes to my brother, Matt, over here. Thank you.
You know, we're gonna allow this only one time because we had this process that we've applied across the state. We're gonna follow it, but we'll allow you to talk.
That's fine. I'm not here to be a troublemaker.
Okay, go ahead.
We rarely get to have opportunities to have this conversation as a community, and I think it's really important that we do.
Proceed.
The Molokai Clean Energy Initiative met for over a year. This is about 2 years ago. In that process of planning for a clean energy future for Molokai, we had the county, we had the state, we had all the stakeholders of Molokai meeting on a regular basis. And this is kind of what I wanted to get to in my previous 3 minutes, was the fact that, you know, what we decided as a community, as a stakeholder, as a people that were doing their homework, you know, Kanoho said, raise your hand, it's a lot of work. Yeah, we've been doing that homework, and Kanoho's been leading the charge. What we came to a conclusion as a community is that one of the best models for us will be some kind of self-owned utility. We realized that Miko wasn't meeting our needs. We realized that other centralized, monopolized corporations aren't going to do it for us either, for the same reasons that have already been mentioned. So, you know, as far as being opposed, I don't want to be the fear-mongering guy that's just opposing something new. I did my homework, I see the track record, and I see a better solution, and that better solution is being looked at right now by Maui County, right, Cal? Isn't it being studied right now? So Maui County is in the process of doing something that we thought of before NextEra even came to the table. And that is looking at a better solution that will truly serve the best interests of the ratepayers, our environment, our culture, and our people. And that is self-ownership of the utility, which is not something that's new and doesn't exist. It exists all over. And so, you know, before we move forward with thinking is NextEra the answer, we need to finish this conversation that was started before they even came to the table. And so I'm glad the county is working on that. I know our community supports the process of looking at how that might work. And so that's what I wanted to end with, is like, not just a no, but what is the solution? That's the solution. So let's take our time and make sure we fully vet that solution before we even consider NextEra. That's all I wanted to say with my extra 3 minutes. Thank you.
Anyone else? Anyone else? If not, we want to thank you. Again, as we said at the beginning, we fully understand there's a lot of other stuff going on today, the football game, the canoe race, and the fact that you all showed up shows how much you guys care about this issue. We will take this will be part of the record. It is being recorded by a court reporter. For those of you who wish to submit further testimony, if you have this brochure, if not, please go and get it from that table. At the back page, you will see a link. You can mail written testimony to that link, and it will be also part of the record before the PUC. Many of us have not been back to this island for several years. We were asked, when was the last time I was here? Personally, Mr. Yamashita, was 2006. It's not often I come here, and I know for the others the same way. Beautiful island. Thank you very much for your hospitality, and good luck to you in keeping Molokai Molokai. Aloha.